with the white blood cells. So, I'm still looking at something in my bone marrow. Type of platelets contain a complex internal structure and an open canalicular system. Do you remember that term? What is it? The canaliculi were the channels in the bone tissue where one lamella of bone got to speak to the other one. All right? So it is a communication system. And it's just like a little wavy looking tubular system. So, these tiny pieces, which are not a complete cell, they have a complex internal structure of, and they have these canaliculi. Their movement is amoeboid, meaning, like the Y'all know how the amoeba move, right? Okay? They put like a little bit of their membrane forward and pull the rest of it. Okay, I love amoeba. And one of the things they do, phagocytosis. They're eating. Normal platelet count, about 130,000 to 400,000 platelets per microliter. I wish I had something to, because everything we've talked about has been per microliter. And I wish I had a little something to show how big a microliter was. I'll have to check it right down. The function. Secrete vasoconstrictors. Vasovessel. Constrict the vessel. Because if something broke that vessel and it's bleeding, we need to stop it. It's that simple. Platelets need to stick together and form the plug that will help seal the small break. Secrete procoagulants, or what we know as clotting factors, to promote clotting. Then initiate the formation of the enzyme to dissolve the clot. Whoa. Also, chemically attract, meaning put off a chemical that will attract neutrophils and monocytes to the area of inflammation. And eat and destroy bacteria. Something that is not even a cell. They're not even a cell. They're a piece. They're a fragment. Secrete growth factors that stimulate mitosis, which is cellular division, to help repair the broken blood vessel. Who? What? No. They are not a cell.
point.
They are a fragment.
Is this in order, or is this just like kind of what they do all?
Pretty much in order. They're busy. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I can't even remember seven things, much less try to do seven. And here's this little teeny, teeny, tiny 130 to 400,000 per microliter things that have to do that stuff. Wow. So, aren't they cute? Look at this. Okay, so, in my bone marrow, I've got this great, big, huge, megakaryocyte. This is like all of those little trabeculae, that spongy bone stuff in the bone, okay? And blood's passing through it. This is trying to show you how big this cell is in comparison to red blood cells and white blood cells. Now look what it does. In one of the little spongy areas of the bone, okay, this cell simply has some of the plasma membrane sticking through one of the little sponge holes. As blood flows by, little pieces simply get broken off. And that's a platelet. Seriously, is that not the cutest thing ever? A megakaryocyte that's just sitting in the bone marrow and in the tissue of the bone, the spongy tissue of the bone, and it's just sitting there.
The red bone marrow.
Just in the spongy tissue. Okay. Where we find bone marrow, and as blood comes moving by in one of these little sinusoids, okay, this big cell, I can't say little, all right, just sitting there, got a little piece of plasma membrane up there. As the blood flows by, pieces just break off, and it's like, toodaloo, bye, go have fun. And we get our teeny tiny little platelet. That's what it sort of looks like. And we're getting the breaking off of our platelets. So the platelets, their material inside of them arises from this cell. This megakaryocyte. Their structure comes from this, and what they have internally is from that megakaryocyte. When we talk about platelet production, this is termed thrombopoiesis. All right? The stem cell, the receptor that helps it become the megakaryote, is from a protein called thrombopoietin. Poyton. So, from the stem cell that gives us the megakaryoblast, all right, which gives you your megakaryocyte. For the blast, it duplicates repeatedly. But the DNA doesn't have to worry about dividing. Meaning, we don't have to wait for it to make a copy of itself and all that sort of fun stuff. So the cells that get duplicated make our megakaryocyte. The nucleus is multi-lobed. It is pretty big, and it simply sits in the bone marrow. The megakaryocyte, like I was showing, live in that spongy tissue portion where they've got a little part that the membrane can move out of and hang out, literally. And as the blood goes by, that little part hanging out just simply gets broken off. Platelets get to circulate for about 5 to 6 days. Almost half are stored in our spleen. Another reason, because remember, the spleen is very important in helping to destroy the used up red blood cells. So another reason the spleen is termed a blood organ. The job of the little platelet is hemostasis, the cessation of bleeding. So here's what's going to happen. We've got our three pathways that I mentioned: the vascular spasm, platelet plug formation, and then blood clot formation, or what's termed coagulation. Now, here's the thing. In the process, these three steps, this is what will occur internally or externally. Now, what? We are constantly, internally, even as you sit here right now, blood vessels are breaking and have to be repaired. Now, things are constantly happening externally that cause a breach to the external environment. Could be a paper cut. You could, prick your finger. Get a splinter. All the way up to massive bleeds, which are a huge breach to the external environment. The process is the same. The first step for hemostasis, the cessation of bleeding, the first step, vascular spasm. Just like the name implies, spasm. Okay? Everybody's kind of had them, right? I would have that little thing, goes down your back, and you just go, ugh. All right? That's a spasm. This will happen in that actual vessel that got breached. Okay? Because what it is, prompt constriction.
Hmm.